गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कोर्स एक्सपीरियंसड बाय द करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर प्लेस्ड इन द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। नाउ बिफोर दैट वी हैव टू डिस्कस व्हाट इज प्लेनिंग्स लेफ्ट हैंड रूल। नाउ द प्लेनिंग्स लेफ्ट हैंड रूल इज यूज्ड टू डिटरमाइन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन द करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर व्हिच इज प्लेस्ड इन मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। ओके, सो व्हाट इज द स्टेटमेंट फॉर प्लेनिंग्स लेफ्ट हैंड रूल। सो स्टेटमेंट इज दैट Planning's left hand rule shows the direction of thrust. Thrust means here force on a current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field. Whenever we are going to place a current carrying conductor in the magnetic field, it experiences magnetic force. Then what is the direction of that magnetic force? That is determined by Planning's left hand rule. So according to Planning's left hand rule, the left hand is held with the thumb. The left hand is held with the thumb. Index finger means here it is a forefinger, so it is a index finger and it is a thumb. So the thumb, index finger and middle finger mutually perpendicular to each other. How to hold the thumb, index finger and middle finger of the left hand here? They are held mutually perpendicular to each other. Then here the forefinger represents the direction of magnetic field and the middle finger represents the direction of current and the thumb indicates the direction of magnetic force acting on the current carrying conductor. So let us assume this is a current carrying conductor. So if there is a current is flowing through this conductor in this direction, okay, that is coming towards you, that current is towards you by using Fleming's left hand rule. So how to determine the force acting on this current carrying conductor when it is placed in the magnetic field? So this middle finger shows the direction of current, this forefinger shows the direction of magnetic field, thumb shows the direction of magnetic force acting on the current carrying conductor because this current carrying conductor is placed in the magnetic field. Then according to the statement, The index finger represents the direction of magnetic field, that is from north to south, direction of magnetic field. Then it is a first point. So the index finger, this is called index finger. Index finger is also called forefinger. The forefinger represents the direction of magnetic field, that is from north to south. This side north and this side south, north to south. Then next, the middle finger represents the direction of flow of current. So this middle finger shows the direction of current. Now once again let us assume this is a current carrying conductor. This duster is a current carrying conductor. That current towards you, then the direction of current can be shown by the middle finger and the direction of magnetic field shown by the forefinger and the direction of force acting on the current carrying conductor represented by thumb. This direction the force acting on the current carrying conductor here in upward direction. In which direction magnetic field is applied here? In the right direction. So in which direction current is there? The current is outward of the plane of the board. Then the direction of current and the thumb represents the direction of force. The direction of force acting on the conductor. Now let us draw the diagram once again. This thumb shows the direction of force acting on the current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field. The forefinger shows the direction. direction of magnetic field. In which direction magnetic field is there? In this direction means in right direction or in forward direction. And in which direction current is there? That is outward, means out of the plane of the board. Now let us draw the diagram. It is a thumb and it is fourth finger or index finger and it is a middle finger. Then the thumb shows the direction of force acting on the current carrying conductor and the fourth finger or index finger shows the direction of magnetic field and the middle finger shows the direction of current. They are mutually perpendicular to each other, but we can't show this line out of the plane of the paper. So that is why I drawn like this here. But all are mutually perpendicular to each other. So this is about Fleming's left hand rule. What is the significance of Fleming's left hand rule? So Fleming's left hand rule is used to determine the direction of force acting on the current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic. Now we are going to discuss about the force on the current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. The experimental setup is shown in the diagram. What about the experimental setup here? There is one conductor. That conductor may be aluminium or copper. And we are going to pass the current through this conductor by connecting that conductor to the battery. Then, what is the direction of flow of current here? The direction of flow of current from positive to negative. See here. The direction of flow of current is from positive to negative. Already we know that what is the direction of current here. Whenever we are going to place a current carrying conductor in between north and south pole of the U-shaped magnet. It is a U-shaped magnet and it is also called horseshoe magnet. Now let us consider it is a current carrying conductor. Below of this current carrying conductor, north is there. And above of this current carrying conductor, south is there. What is the direction of magnetic field? The direction of magnetic field is upward. Then that direction of current is towards you. Whenever the current is towards you, the direction of current can be shown by which one? The direction of current can be shown by the middle finger and the direction of magnetic field. Okay, that can be shown by fourth finger. This is a fourth finger. And what is the direction of force acting here? Because the direction of magnetic field is upward here. The direction of magnetic field is upward, the direction of current towards you. Then what is the direction of force acting on this current carrying conductor? That is to the left. Now it is the force acting on the current carrying conductor. That is to the left. It is here. By reversing the direction of current and by reversing the direction of magnetic field, there is a reversing the direction of force acting on the current carrying conductor. So there is an expression for the magnetic force experienced by current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field. What is that expression? But that expression is not for you. You will study about that one in second PUC. What is the expression for magnetic force experienced by current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field? That is F is equal to B into I into L into sine theta. Then what is B here? B is magnetic field. What is I here? I is current in the conductor. And what is L here? Length of the conductor. And what is theta here? Theta is nothing but it is the angle between the length vector and magnetic field vector. It is the angle between the length vector and magnetic field vector. So, when the current carrying conductor experiences maximum magnetic force, only when the length vector and magnetic field vector both are perpendicular to each other. So, if magnetic field vector is perpendicular to the length vector, then theta is how much? The angle between the magnetic field vector and length vector is 90 degrees. Then, what about magnetic force here? F is equal to B into I into L. Because sine 90 is how much? That is 1. Only then, the conductor experiences, current carrying conductor experiences magnetic force only when that current carrying conductor places perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field. See here. It is the direction of magnetic field and it is the length of the conductor. The direction of magnetic field and the length of the conductor both are perpendicular to each other. What is the angle between them? The angle between them is 90 degree. Then it experiences maximum magnetic force, that is to the left. By knowing the direction of magnetic field and by knowing the direction of current, we can determine the direction of force acting on the current carrying conductor. See, according to this diagram, the direction of current towards U, that is from V to A, it is E now, it is A now. What is the direction of magnetic field? The direction of magnetic field is upward. And what is the force acting on the current carrier conductor? That is in the direction of thumb. Here thumb represents the direction of magnetic force acting on the conductor. In which direction the magnetic force acting on the current carrying conductor here? In the left direction. If we are going to reverse the direction of magnetic field, suppose to be, I will take here now and here so, what is the direction of magnetic field now? The direction of magnetic field is down. And if we are going to reverse the direction of current, so here the direction of current from B to A, I will reverse the direction of current from A to B, then the direction of force acting on the current carrying conductor also reverses. We are going to determine that one by Fleming's left hand rule. The magnetic force experienced by a current carrying conductor is shown in the diagram or is shown in the figure. Is shown in the figure. Then, if the current carrying conductor is placed parallel to the direction of magnetic field, see here, this is a current carrying conductor. This current carrying conductor is placed parallel to the magnetic field. Magnetic field is up, the current carrying conductor is also up. The length vector and magnetic field vector both are in same direction. The length vector and magnetic field vector both are in same direction. What is the angle between them? Angle between them is 0. When the angle between them is 0, then sin 0 is 0. There is no magnetic force experienced by current carrying conductor which is placed parallel to the direction of magnetic field. Okay, remember this one, it is very important. Then, the magnetic force experienced by the current carrying conductor due to the interaction between the magnetic force due to the current carrying conductor and also the due to the external magnetic field. So, what is the cause of magnetic force experienced by the current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field? The magnetic force acting on the current carrying conductor is due to interaction between the magnetic field due to the current carrying conductor. This current carrying conductor also produces magnetic field and also external magnetic field is there. Means how many magnetic fields are there? Two magnetic fields are there. One magnetic field is due to the current in the conductor. Another magnetic field is due to the external magnet. Means that is called external magnetic field. So the magnetic force acting on the current carrying conductor is due to the interaction between magnetic field due to every current carrying conductor produces magnetic field. Through this conductor current is flowing, means this one produces magnetic field and also external magnetic field is there. That external magnetic field is applied by using the horseshoe magnet. Magnetic field due to the current carrying conductor. Magnetic field due to the current carrying conductor. Current carrying conductor. And external magnetic field. External magnetic field due to horseshoe magnet. External magnetic field due to horseshoe magnet. Or U-shaped magnet. So this is about the force experienced by the current carrying conductor placed in the magnetic field and it is the experimental setup, means it is the diagram shown for the experimental setup. So when the current carrying conductor experiences maximum magnetic force, only when the length vector means the conductor is placed, current carrying conductor is placed perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field. It is the direction of current, that current is towards you, and the direction of magnetic field is up. Then what is the direction of force acting on this current carrying conductor? That is to the left. But we can't show this current towards you. That is why I have shown like this. Okay. So it is about the force experienced by current carrying conductor, and also what happens when the direction of current reverses and direction of magnetic field reverses and magnetic force also reverses. So this is about the magnetic force experienced by current carrying conductor placed in magnet. Now let us some in-text questions. What is first question now? Consider a circular loop of wire lying on the plane of the table. Consider a circular loop of wire lying on the plane of the table. Let the current pass through the loop in which direction? Clockwise direction. What is the direction of flow of current here? That is clockwise. Clockwise means here, this end of the wire is connected to positive of the battery and this end of the wire is connected to negative of the battery. Then what is the direction of flow of current here? Positive to negative. It is a battery. So in which direction the current is flowing? In clockwise direction. That is very important. Apply right hand thumb rule to find out the direction of the magnetic field inside and outside the loop. What is the direction of magnetic field inside the loop and what is the direction of magnetic field outside the loop? By how to find the direction of magnetic field here? By using right hand thumb rule. Let us consider, this is a table. There is a coil lying on the table. So what is the shape of the coil here? Circular coil. So through this part the current is in which direction? Upward direction. Here magnetic field is out and here the magnetic field is in. Like this. Means outside the loop the magnetic field is emerging out of the plane of the table, but inside the loop the magnetic field is emerging into the plane of the table. Then again by using right hand thumb rule to this part, means by applying right hand thumb rule to this part now. So here the current is down. Here through this part current is down, that is towards you. Then what is the direction of magnetic field? Here the magnetic field is out and here the magnetic field is in. Always nail indicate the in and this part indicate the out. Here the magnetic field is out and here the magnetic field is in. Here it is out and here it is in. Again, here it is out and here it is in. Same, out and in. Then what we concluded from this right hand thumb rule? So we concluded that outside the loop the magnetic field is emerging out of the plane of the table. From the figure. The magnetic field, means the direction of magnetic field is out of the plane of the table. From the figure, the magnetic field is from the figure outside the loop, magnetic field is out of the plane of the table. Is out of the plane of the table. And inside the loop, see here, outside the loop, the magnetic field is out of the plane of the table. And here also, the magnetic field is out of the plane of the table. And inside the loop, the magnetic field is into the plane of the table. The magnetic field is into the plane of the table. So
So it is the answer.
What we concluded from this figure now, your magnetic field is out of the plane of the table, and your magnetic field is into the plane of the table. Inside the loop, magnetic field is into the plane of the table, and outside the loop, the magnetic field is out of the plane of the table. Now, next we are going to discuss what is the diagram for uniform magnetic field. Second question, the diagram for uniform magnetic field is that here the magnetic field lines are parallel to each other. It is the diagram for uniform magnetic field. At every point the magnetic field is same and these magnetic field lines are parallel to each other. Now it is called uniform magnetic field. Third question is that, so it is related to solenoid. Inside the solenoid the magnetic field is maximum, it never be zero. And as we are moving towards the end of the solenoid, the magnetic field goes on decreases, but not increases. Because at the end of the solenoid, the magnetic field is half of the magnetic field at the center of the solenoid. It is a solenoid. Already we discussed about solenoid. At the center of the solenoid, the magnetic field is maximum. That is how much? Mu naught into N into R. But as we are moving towards the end of the solenoid, the magnetic field goes on decreases here. At the end of the solenoid, the magnetic field is half of the magnetic field at the center of the solenoid. This side also same. But it is never the same at all points. It will be changed. At the center it is maximum. As we are moving towards the ends, this magnetic field goes on decreases. Okay, this is about third question. I hope you will answer second and third question.